Hi viewer, I welcome you to Edim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Mathematics Form 3, lesson number 10. The topic it is Approximation and Errors. I'm your tutor, Rusi Mudoni. Welcome. Our lesson course today, we are going to look at the accuracy and errors. That is the absolute errors, the relative error, round off, and then we look at the truncate error. We start by looking at the accuracy and errors. What is errors? What is accuracy? Generally, or everyday's activity, it is given in either measurement, decimal place, weight, we weigh them, but we cannot get the accurate measurement. There is the reason as to why you must come up with at least approximation, accuracy, absolute error. So that is the reason as to why errors is supposed to be studied. So we start by looking at the absolute error. Absolute error, it is a half of the least unit of measurement used, unless otherwise stated. So you must have the least unit. For example, we have 2.348 centimeters to the nearest thousandth, then it is absolute error. We just take the last unit, it is going to the thousand. So I'm just going to take a half of the thousand, which is a half of 0.001. Remember, it is going to the thousand. And in that case, now we get 0.0005. That is the absolute error. Number two, example two, we have 5 kgs, it absolute error. What is the least unit? It is in kg, 1 kg, once. So in that case now, it absolute error, I'm just going to take a half of once, one, which is supposed to give me 0.5 kgs. So with that, at least you have an idea of what we refer to it as absolute error. So it is a half of the least unit of the measurement that is used, unless it is stated otherwise. Let us go now to the relative error. Now, when we talk about the relative error, it is the ratio of the absolute error in relation to actual measurement, in relation to the actual measurement. Relative error, it is the ratio when we take now the absolute error divided by the actual measurement. The formula I've given it. That is when now we get the relative error. So we must first of all get the absolute error, then we divide by the actual measurement, what we were given. Then there is something else which we refer to it as the percentage error. How do we get it? We just take now the relative error times 100. That is the absolute error divided by the actual measurement multiplied by 100. If at all you get this one, it's supposed to be a series. We start with the absolute error. Then we go to the relative error. And after that, you go to the percentage error. Let us take examples. We have the first example there. The capacity of the gland is stated as 2,000 milliliters to the nearest 10 milliliters. This one, now it is stated. The limit within, find the limit within the capacity lies, and the percentage error. So, because now my case, now this one, it is stating I'm just going to use that. So it is a half of 10. That is how I get the absolute error. Yeah, now I'm not taking the list. No, but it has been stated. So in that case, now I get it is 5 milliliters. What is the lowest, the limit we have to get the lowest possible capacity and the highest possible capacity? How do I get the lowest? The lowest, I get it by taking the actual measurement or the measurement given minus the absolute error. And the highest possible capacity, I'm supposed to take it by the measurement given plus the absolute error. So in that case, I'm getting 1,995 and 2,005. That is the limit. Now, how do I get now the percentage error? The percentage error, I would take the absolute error divided by the actual measurement. Already, we have calculated the absolute error, which is 5. So it's supposed to be 5 divided by 2,000. That is the measurement that we are given, which you refer to it as the actual measurement, then multiplied by 100. And the answer is supposed to be 0.25%. That is the percentage error. Then we still have another example. We have example 2. An angle was measured to the nearest degree. We have an angle that was measured to the nearest degree as 40 degrees. Then calculate the maximum possible value of the stated angle. Then minimum possible value of the stated angle. Then the percentage error. So what is the risk value? Before even going to the calculation, we just get the risk value, which is 1. So in that case, now I'm just going to get the half of 1, which is supposed to be 0.5. So maximum possible value is supposed to be 40 plus 0.5. Minimum is supposed to be a 40 minus 0.5. So I get the maximum as 40.95 and the minimum as 39.5. The percentage error, I'm supposed to get the absolute error divided by the actual measurement, which is supposed to be 0.5 divided by 40 times 100. That is giving me 1.25%. Then we have the round off and the truncation error. Already you have done the rounding off. We have a number there, 1.66666. Then we have the it being rounded off, and then it gives us different fractions. And in that case, now we have 1.7 and 1.66. So 17 over 10, it is 1.7 when we have rounded off. So when you truncate it, we just get 5 over 3. So in that case, when we subtract, I get a 1 over 30. That is the round off error. Then the truncation error, we just get, it is, when we truncate it, we just get 0.32. And here, now it is stated to 2 significant figures. So with that, now we get the truncation error. It's supposed to be 0.007. We go to the next example. We have the number 2.5 has been rounded off to one decimal place, the reach and the relative error. That is the way it's supposed to be calculated. The risk value there, it is 10. So the next one I'm supposed to have half times 0.1, which is equal to 0.05. The upper limit, we hand, the lower limit we subtract. Relative error, which is absolute error, divided by the actual measurement times 100, which is equal to 2%. Let us go to the activity for today. That is the way you are supposed to get the question, do the question. For more reference, you can get the KLB 2003 secondary book 3. For more information, get us through the SMS, through the YouTube, through the Facebook, and also through the Twitter.